Music played quite a lot of important role during the time of our struggle in South Africa. It was the only way that, you know, we could get, you know, the regime to listen. Through music, they could hear what we were saying.
Vusi Malesela can't remember a time when he wasn't singing. Growing up during apartheid in South Africa, music was always there for him.
Music is very, very, very much important in every walks of life, all over the world. So for South Africans, I think from the painful history that we come from, music was the only thing that gave us courage.
The melodies sung by this young revolutionary on a homemade guitar invariably struck chords of political and social significance.
I walk into this
when I cast it in a vote,
even
though I was voting for my mother, I was voting for my grandfather, my great-grandfather, who had never given the chance to vote at all.
Although his early renown came largely from a brutal regime through threats and even imprisonment, eventually the power of his message, his songs of freedom and peace carried through and earned him much respect from poet activists and fellow musicians all over the globe.
And not just to take it from it, and will you ring the bells when you come back? Will you beat the drums when you come back?
In 1994, Vusi was asked to perform at the inauguration of South Africa's new president, Nelson Mandela. Vusi is now an ambassador to Mandela's 46664 campaign, a global initiative to raise awareness of AIDS and HIV. Vusi proudly promotes Mandela's message of peace and hope for the country through his worldwide touring. Through six continents of touring, Vusi continues to shine on the global stage as one of Africa's brightest musical stars, spreading his message and music. In 2003, Americans caught their first glimpse of Vusi in the Lauda documentary, Amandla, A Revolution in Four-Part Harmony, a film that charts South Africans' long-time struggle for racial equality. The accompanying soundtrack highlighted Vusi. Later that year, Vusi's voice sang out again with his first U.S. release for ATO Records. The voice led to further international recognition.
For that woman who jumped the fence is pregnant and still gave birth to a healthy child. Amanda.
2005, Oscar-winning feature film Tsotsi highlights Vusi's vocals on the haunting musical score, and the accompanying soundtrack heavily features Vusi's music. Vusi's voice can be heard on Josh Groban's new album, Awake, and Dave Matthews Band, Best of What's Around. On March 6, 2007, ATO Records will release the highly anticipated new studio album, Guiding Star, featuring musical guests and friends he's met along the way. Dave Matthews, Jem, Derek Trucks, Ladysmith Black Mambazo, and Xavier Rudd. Guiding Star remains true to Vusi's roots. The album was recorded on a farm in rural South Africa and includes the talents of numerous South African guests. Guiding Star is a hybrid of folk, world, blues, and soul, one that connects South Africa's apartheid-scarred past with its promise for a better future. One of the hardest things to learn as a musician is when to not only recognize inspiration, but when to trust and follow it. That trust in his gift is at the root of Guiding Star.
But I'm sharing the other.